Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the top stories from across the globe. Let's take a look at today's headlines. Amazon workers in Germany go on strike as mobilization efforts increase across countries. Protests against femicide in Mexico following custodial death of migrant woman. UN report confirms French airstrike killed 19 unarmed civilians in Mali. ATI steel mill workers launch indefinite strike for fair compensation in the US. Palestinians commemorate 45th Land Day against Israeli occupation. Amazon workers across six locations in Germany have gone on a four-day strike. The call to strike was issued by the service trade union Verdi. Workers began the strike action starting with a night shift on March 28. The distribution centers in Rheinberg, Werne, Koblenz, Bad Hersfeld, and Leipzig are participating in the action. Workers are demanding that Amazon raise wages and agree to a collective agreement for good and healthy work. Verdi has stated that the work stoppages mark the unofficial start of industry-wide wage negotiations. Unions are calling for an increase in wages by 4.5% and at least €45 over the next 12 months. Verdi member Orhan Akman has also stated that the conditions at Amazon have made it impossible for workers to adhere to COVID safety guidelines. The union is also demanding that collective wage agreements should be declared generally binding in all federal states. This means that these agreements will also apply to companies which are not a part of an employer's association or collective agreements. However, the declaration of general applicability can only be granted after a joint application by Verdi and the German Trade Association. The association has so far refused to join this agreement. The strike in Germany follows just a week after thousands of Amazon workers in Italy led a nationwide strike. Workers at the Amazon facility in Bessemer in the US are also deciding if they want to form a union. The National Labor Relations Board is currently counting around 5,800 ballots after a seven-week voting process. If the vote passes, the workers will join the Retail, Wholesale and Department Store Union. This will make the Bessemer warehouse the first Amazon facility in the US to unionize. In our next story, we go to Mexico, where hundreds took to the streets to protest against femicides on March 30th. Outrage grew following reports of the death of a Salvadoran woman in police custody. 36-year-old Victoria Salazar was detained by four police officers outside a supermarket on March 27th. The incident took place in the town of Tulum. Footage posted online showed a female police officer kneeling on her back. Three male officers were seen standing by as Salazar was crying and saying she couldn't breathe. An autopsy report has suggested that she died because of a broken neck. The Quintana Roo state prosecutor has announced that his office will prepare femicide charges against the four police officers. Victoria Salazar has been living in Mexico since 2018 and she is survived by two daughters. Over 300 protesters held a demonstration on Tuesday and marched to City Hall to demand justice for Salazar and other victims of femicide. As reported by El País, 100 women and girls also lay down in protest outside the municipal palace. Activists have also highlighted the issues of classism, xenophobia and gender and police violence in light of Salazar's murder. Nearly 1,000 cases of femicide were reported in Mexico in 2020 alone. A UN investigation has concluded that 19 unarmed civilians were killed in a French drone strike in Mali. The report was released on March 30th by the United Nations mission in the country. France had previously claimed that the strike had targeted armed rebels affiliated with a terrorist group. Based on interviews with hundreds of people, the UN has confirmed that the strike hit a wedding party in the Bounty village. 22 men were killed in the attack, out of which only three were armed. The three men are believed to have affiliations with the Katiba Sarma group, which has alleged links with Al-Qaeda. The French military had claimed that it had killed 30 rebel fighters in the strike on January 3rd. It had also denied claims that the strike had hit a wedding party, instead calling it a gathering of fighters. The UN report has argued that the attack violated the accepted principles of conduct of hostilities. There were over 100 people present at the wedding party, a majority of whom were civilians. As such, the report argues that they were persons protected under international humanitarian law. Six civilians were also killed in a similar airstrike by France in northern Mali on March 25th. Workers at the largest specialty steel mill in the United States have gone on an indefinite strike. Over 1,300 workers across nine plants of Allegheny Technologies Incorporated, or ATI, began picketing on March 30th. The strike began on March 29th after workers rejected last-minute offers made by the company. Organized under the United Steelworkers Union, workers have been in negotiations with the company for a fair four-year contract. A major issue has been the rate of increase in wages as the workers at ATI have not received a raise since 2014. The union has demanded $5,000 as a first-year payment. It has also asked for a staggered wage hike starting with 3% in the second year, 3.5% in the third year, and 4% in the fourth year. However, the company only offered $3,000 in first-year payments and a total wage hike of 9%. Workers have also raised concerns regarding the company's restructuring plans. These include bringing in a large number of casual workers to eliminate around 400 unionized jobs. The company has also introduced reductions and changes in healthcare coverage. Workers are demanding greater transparency and consultation on shift times and pensions for people who lost their jobs due to shutdowns or layoffs in other plants. And in our final story, we take a look at the 45th Land Day observed by the Palestinian people on March 30th. The day affirms the rights of Palestinians over their lands and the right to return for Palestinian refugees. The occasion is marked by vigils and the planting of olive trees as a form of resistance against the Israeli occupation. However, sources reported that several marches had been disrupted by Israeli forces on Monday. People gathered at a rally in the Nablus governorate were reportedly also attacked with tear gas. Here is a video feature on the historic day.
أكيد اليوم يوم مميز بالنسبة للشعب الفلسطيني هو يوم الأرض اللي ذكرى بتضل راسخة في عقولنا وقلوبنا وبنيجي نحتفل فيه نتذكر الشهداء ونتذكر الأرض
And that's all the time we have for this episode of the International Daily Roundup. For more such stories and videos, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Thank you for watching.